Hi, let's talk about the functions of the digestive system. In terms of the GI or digestive system, there are two major functions. The first is to serve as a pathway for fluid and nutrients. So we would bring materials in through the mouth, the oral cavity, through the pharynx, down the esophagus into the stomach, through the small intestines, eventually through the large intestines, the rectum, and then out the anus. The goal here is to absorb these fluids and nutrients from the lumen, or the central portion of the tube of the gut, into the body, which would be into the cardiovascular and lymphatic systems. The other basic function or major function of the GI system is to help modulate the immune system locally with respect to the surface of the gut tube. In terms of the fluid and nutrient pathways, there are six basic processes that are going to modulate these materials. The first being ingestion. Now, a typical human is going to take in about 3 to 4 liters of water and somewhere between 2,000 to 3,000 calories per day. Of course, this is going to vary with respect to activity level, general metabolism, and diet goals, but on average, 3 to 4 liters of water and 2,000 to 3,000 calories daily. So this comes in through the mouth, typically, and your GI system is then going to secrete its own fluid into the lumen. And so we go from the process of ingestion to secretion. There's also the mixing and the propulsion of the materials within the lumen. And so the goal here is to bring as much of the contents of the ingested materials into contact with the various chemicals and materials secreted by the GI system. This is greatly enhanced through the processes of mixing and propulsion. There are layers of smooth muscle that are embedded within the walls of the digestive system. Some of this smooth muscle is arranged in longitudinal layers, and as it contracts, it's responsible for the inchwise movement of peristalsis. And some of those layers of smooth muscle are arranged in circular fibers, and that's responsible for segmentation contractions, which can either move materials forward or backwards, depending on how that smooth muscle is contracted. Now, there are also processes of digestion occurring, and this can occur at the physical level, such as teeth acting upon materials that are ingested, the smooth muscle sort of churning those materials with the digestive secretions. Or at the chemical level, we can have various enzymes and acids mix with very large particulate matter to help break that down into smaller portions that may be then absorbed by the lining of the GI system. And this process of absorption moves materials from the lumen of the GI. So if we were to conceptualize the gut tube like so, if the ingested materials are here, that space is actually outside of the body, and we want to move those materials inside the body. So into the capillaries, whether they be cardiovascular capillaries or lymphatic capillaries, so that we can then move that material up to the liver for processing and send it out to the rest of the body. Any materials which are within the lumen of the GI tract that are not absorbed are then dehydrated down, not totally, but largely, and turned into feces, which are then defecated from the rectum through the anal canal, out the anus, and outside of the body. Now, there's also an immune component to the digestive system. You can think of the digestive system or the GI tract as a physical barrier between the outside, or the stuff that's within the lumen, and the inside of the body. that space has a remarkably large surface area. So from the mouth down through into the anal canal, there's approximately 32 square meters of surface area. That's roughly twice the size of a parking space. And throughout the wall is embedded a lot of lymphoid or lymphatic tissue that hosts lymphocytes and various other cells that are capable of defending the body from any pathogenic material or anything that might mean the body harm. Now, one of the latest hot topics of the GI system is that of the microbiome. Now, within the GIT, we have the microbiota. The microbiota references all of the bacteria or fungi or protozoans that live within the lumen of the gastrointestinal tract. Now, the microbiome are the sum total of all of the genomes of those living creatures. And what's significant here is many of these living organisms, especially the bacteria, are beneficial to the human. So they form this microecological community that contains genes which are capable of metabolizing substances, synthesizing vitamins, and communicating with the body's own immune system. So to greatly enhance metabolism, to help maintain a healthy gut and a healthy body. And this is a greatly underappreciated service that's performed by the microbiota for people. So as we'll see throughout the discussions that we'll have regarding the anatomy of the digestive system, I want you to pull forward these ideas of ingestion and secretion and absorption and elimination and where these processes are occurring as we discuss the anatomy. Thank you.